Hi you guys, Lindsay here. Welcome back to my channel, Inside the Hem.
The StyleMaker Fabrics Fall Style Tour is well underway. We have seen so many great makes so far, and today is the day for the big reveal for what I made. But before I show you, let me talk to you a little bit about the inspiration. Michelle, the owner of StyleMaker Fabrics, takes great pride in finding fabrics that are reminiscent of ready-to-wear. She follows the trends closely, and her store reflects that. She sent me these photos from a trip to Nordstrom, noting the print mixing trend. After I saw these, I started seeing print mixing everywhere, thus the inspiration for the dress I made. This is McCall's 7894, which was thoughtfully designed with print mixing in mind, even if the sample wasn't sewn to reflect that. I made view B, but had to add that slit from the view C and D. The pattern is described as a dress with a fitted lined bodice with invisible side zipper, raised shaped waistline, and sleeve and skirt variations. Views A, B, and D have elasticized sleeves, and no provisions were provided for above waist or hip adjustments, which we will get to in a little bit. But back to the fabric. So to pull off print mixing, your fabrics need to be different but similar at the same time. The easiest way to do that is with color. And so when Michelle found this collection of rayon challis that had all the same colors mixed in different ways, she knew they would make the perfect print mix. There are actually 8 fabrics that are a part of this collection, so calling them down to pick just a few that would work for the dress was quite hard. I knew I wanted to make something closer to the Kate Spade inspiration dress and would be using more contrast fabrics than the pattern illustrated. So I started making these little, definitely not to scale, mock-ups just to see how the colors would balance in the overall garment. I started with 3 fabrics and then ended up adding a 4th one. I just couldn't help myself. You can see that I ended up making the bodice out of 2 different fabrics, made the sleeves 2 different fabrics as well, and also made the skirt out of 3 fabrics. To pull this off on the cutting table, I took my time writing down a list of each fabric and the pattern pieces I would need to cut from each. After that, I was off to alter the pattern, which proved to be a little difficult. Remember how the pattern description said there were no provisions for above waist or hip adjustments? Well, I'm a pear shape, so I needed to cut a size 14 bust, 18 waist, and 22 hip in order for this dress to fit. I had to add my own waist and hip lines and graded out the side seams. The skirt is a little slimmer than you would think. I can usually make a straight size from my waist down, but not for this pattern. I had to grade out to accommodate my hips and the wearing ease. It was not difficult, but it was just time consuming since there are so many pattern pieces. Once I got that sorted, it was time to cut. This is also easier than it may seem. I cut all the pattern pieces in a single layer of fabric. The only trick with this is you just need to be super mindful of cutting one pattern piece with the fabric right side up and the other with the wrong side up, so you have 2 mirror images of the pattern pieces. Other than that, it's business as usual. Finally, it was time to sew, and the dress came together really easily. I lined the bodice and did my trick to enclose the sleeve seam allowances. I also took great care to sew French seams everywhere I could, so the insides look as nice as the outsides. Unfortunately, there is no way to fully enclose the waist seam since the bodice is a wrap, so that one went through my serger. I installed my favorite zippers for lightweight fabrics, hemmed her, and she was good to go. And now I want all my garments to have mixed prints. If I were going to do this again, I think the fabrics with the black backgrounds would be so fun together. It would be a slightly subtler print mix, which I also think would look so chic. And not for nothing, but these fabrics are also awesome on their own as well. The quality of the challis is very good. They are definitely lightweight, but still have some substance to them. They are not the paper-thin challis of my nightmares. But wait, there's more. You know I couldn't just make a dress, right? So to go with my new frock, I also made a stretch suede moto jacket in the most beautiful emerald green that just so happens to match the green in the black fabric of my skirt perfectly. Mark my words, emerald is the new navy. The pattern I used is the beloved Butterick 6169 by Lizette. And after making this suede version, I can definitely see why. This semi-fitted lined jacket has shoulder pads, seam detail, welt pockets, exposed zipper, and two-piece sleeves. I made no alterations to the pattern, and it fits like a dream. I did make a couple of changes to the construction, though. First, I omitted the welt pocket bag and just sewed on the welt tabs for a faux welt pocket. The pocket bag piece is so small, I knew it would be useless for me for practical reasons, so no need to go through the trouble of sewing them. I also used the bagged lining method to attach the lining to the jacket. The pattern calls for an immense amount of hand sewing, and ain't nobody got time for that, especially when there's an easier way that produces just as beautiful results. This stretch suede comes in a slew of colors and makes a great jacket, obviously, but I would love to have a little mini skirt from it too. It actually has a teensy bit of drape, so it would also make a great dress. It really is a powerhouse that could be made into so many garments. The stretch quality of it makes it super comfortable to wear too, which is just icing on the cake. It was pretty easy to sew as far as suede goes. I used a combination of pins and wonder clips to keep the raw edges together. I had to try a few needles, but ended up having success with a size 90 stretch needle. A walking foot would certainly help, but I did not use mine. At the ironing board, I used a pretty high heat with light steam and a pressing cloth and found that the seams pressed pretty flat. For seams with a lot of bulk, like the welt tabs and the facing, I used my tailor's clapper to help flatten those. So, there you have it, my 2019 fall style tour outfit. Let me know what you think of it and if you'd ever give print mixing a try in the comment section below. I know I threw a lot at you today. I have a ton of links and information in the description box, so be sure to read through that. It will probably answer a lot of the questions you might have, but if you have others that aren't addressed there, of course, please feel free to leave them in the comment section as well. So Lori from Girls in the Garden, which you guys may remember from Social Mashup, is actually up tomorrow on the style tour. So I've seen a little sneak peek of what she made, and I think you guys are really going to love it. You can head over to Stylemaker Fabric's blog to get a recap of the style tour so far. And be sure to check out Lori's blog, girlsinthegarden.net, to see what she made tomorrow. But that is going to do it for me today. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all very soon. Bye!